My name is Nava Gurung, and I am Development and Humanitarian Relief Coordinator at PWRDF. So what is food security? Food security is a situation in which five A's are met. And what are those five A's? First, availability. When food is available to all people at all times. Accessibility, when people have economic as well as physical access to food. Third, acceptability, when the food that they have is culturally acceptable. Fourth, appropriateness, when food is nutritious and free from harmful chemicals or other substances. And the fifth, agency, in which people can act or influence policies and processes that affect their lives and livelihoods. So whose food security we are talking about? Well, globally, there is one in every eight people who face the risk of hunger and malnutrition. Usually these are the people who are affected by disasters, whether this is man-made or natural, or are living in marginal societies, in impoverished ways. In majority of cases, these are women, children, and other vulnerable groups, such as people living with HIV and AIDS. So how does PWRDF and its partners help these people achieve their food security in long run? One way of doing it is by weaving three distinct but very related components together. These three components are forming and working the self-help groups, encouraging people to do home gardening or produce food in whatever space that's available in the patches of land in their home state, and third, by creating hygiene and nutrition education and awareness. So I'll talk about all these three components one by one. First, about self-help groups. Let me start by an example. There are about 70,000 Sri Lankan Tamil refugees who are currently living in more than 100 refugee camps in Tamil Nadu state of India. And we've been working with them for almost 3 decades now. And the self-help groups there are the backbone of the programming of the refugee community. They are self-identified and self-selected. They make their own rules. In other words, they are self-governance. And the emphasis is first into saving, and then members, when there's critical, some level of capital that's built up, then they can borrow, members can borrow their own money from the group fund to run their micro enterprises, to support the education of their children, and also for other emergencies such as medical emergencies. When the self-help groups become mature and experienced, they are not only tied up with the saving and credit, but they go beyond that and they bring men and children into this journey. And they also influence other potentially harmful cultural practices such as dowry, such as early marriages, such as alcoholism in the camp, or other addiction issues that affect their lives and livelihoods. In addition to that, another agency of them is that they connect with external stakeholders such as various department agencies of the government to access the support that the governments might be making available for them. The second is about home gardening, also known as kitchen gardening or home state food production. The idea is that even landless people have some spaces around their house, and they can use very creatively the roof, fences, or even balcony, or any part of the land to grow vegetables, fruits, medicinal plants, herbs, or other condiments that can provide a diversity of nutrients to their family members. And sometimes there's even access, and they can share and sell locally in the community. So this, the home gardening becomes important new source of nutritious, fresh and nutritious food for the family members at the household level, and as well as the community members at the community level. The third component is awareness on hygiene and nutrition. And this is very important because usually pregnant women, nursing women, and children, especially those up to the age of 5 years, and other people living with HIV/AIDS have special nutrition requirement. And this needs to, the awareness needs to be created, not only among the women, but other household members, for example, the husbands, mother-in-laws and father-in-laws, so that they become aware that these women and children, they need special nutrition at the household level. Often at times, it's women who eat less or who don't get nutritious meal at household. So this awareness should be created. And when it's connected to the gardening program, then they know what nutrition they need and what to grow at the garden. So that connection is established there. And so to do the awareness in nutrition, various methodologies are used. It could be simple courtyard session for a couple of hours when women are available. When they meet first at their self-help group meetings, they come together and then they can talk about, okay, this is the local vegetable that's rich in iron, for example. This is the vegetable that is rich in vitamin A. So they can produce their own nutritious food in their own garden, and then self-help groups can encourage that among their members.
So all this work do not happen without challenges. There are three major challenges that PWRDF and its partners have faced in this work. First is about women's work, because women are already overworked in their households and in their community. So when we ask them to come and join the self-help groups, and there are lots of other work involved in the self-help groups, we got to be careful not to overwhelm and not to overload them. And also, since it's self-selected and self-governed, it takes a lot of energy right in the beginning. So this is a challenge. Sometimes group fall out. They need a lot of encouragement and motivation in the beginning, especially in the beginning. The second challenge is around home gardening. And this relates to integrating animals and birds, small animals and birds, and vegetable and other plant materials that they grow. Especially because integrating animals is important because it provides manure and they provides an opportunity for nutrient recycling. So low-cost farming is encouraged because then they don't have to go out and buy fertilizer and other chemicals. But at the, and also having animal would provide them some animal protein and nutrients which are potentially not available from vegetable or plant-based diet. But integrating these two can be very challenging, because if you let loose your two hens or five hens for 15 minutes, all your vegetables or plants would be gone. So you need a strategy of how to control, keep the hen in a controlled environment and the vegetable in a controlled way, in such a way that they help each other but they don't hinder each other. So there's a challenge, and the support is needed from project, and encouragement is also needed, and they also discuss among themselves in when they meet in self-help groups.
Third challenge is about gender and cultural related household food consumption practices. And it directly relates to the nutrition that is available to women and children, women and girls. For example, if egg or milk is and other nutritious food is available at household, either through their own production or by from market, it may go to, usually it would go to men or boys, and it may not necessarily go to women and girls. So how to change that, and how they share nutritious food together equally among the family members, and even for women who are pregnant and nursing, and also children who are below the age of 5, is important. And so this needs time to change those practices over time. So these are the three challenges we have encountered in the field, and those issues are discussed at the self-help group meetings, and also at home visits at household levels. And over time, we hope things will change for the better.